माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम राजेंद्र राय फ्रॉम एलबीएम पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर, प्रेजेंटिंग दिस डिजिटल वीडियो फॉर योर लर्निंग। डियर स्टूडेंट, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो यू हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम दैट कम्स अंडर द लाइफ प्रोसेस नंबर 2 आफ्टर द न्यूट्रिशन एंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन। इट टेक्स प्लेस इन वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम of which structure you have already studied. Dear student, one thing I would like to add here in the structural part, that the rib cage are formed and these rib cage get controlled by the diaphragm. These rib cage can get controlled by the diaphragm, and these rib cage is having the two very important organs as well as the three important organs: liver, heart, and lungs in the human body. And these rib cage are made up of bones as well as the cartilage. So this is the flexible one. It becomes flexible by the contraction and relaxation of this diaphragm. So this is the diaphragm. Diaphragm, rib cage. This is the rib cage which protect these delicate organs like heart, respiratory system, lungs, trachea, and liver, etc. in the thoracic region of the human body. Dear student, come to the next, that is the process of respiration, the physiology of respiration. And the physiology of respiration, what I have told you already, that get completed in three parts. Number one is a breathing. So dear student, breathing means the inhaling the oxygen, inhaling the air inside our body, inside our lung, by the nostrils and by the mouth cavity, especially the passage of the air in nostril. And that nostril, suppose this is the head, so there will be the nostril. This nostril get connected. This is the nasal cavity, and it get connected with this. Nasal passage, and the trachea starts from here. This is the air passage, and after this air passage, this is the nasal cavity, whole throat region. After this, the trachea starts in the thoracic region. So this is the air entering into it and coming inside this trachea, as well as the carbon dioxide going out from this same passage. The passage is the same. The process is two. Number one, inhalation, and number two, exhalation. So number one, inhalation means incoming of the air by the nostrils through the air passage and going to the trachea as well as the lung. That is called inhalation. Exhalation means the carbon dioxide get released via this trachea and nasal cavity, air passage, nasal cavity through nostril. That is called the exhalation. So inhalation and exhalation is like this. So this is the inhalation and exhalation, the process. That is called breathing. So breathing can be defined as the process of the inhaling the air and exhaling the carbon dioxide. That is called breathing. Dear student, in this breathing, the breathing get controlled by the diaphragm. That is the muscular band which separate the thoracic region and abdominal region. And इट रिलैक्स एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विच रिजल्ट्स द एक्सपेंशन एंड रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ द एक्सपेंशन एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ द रिब केज. इट फैसिलिटेट द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ द लंग एज वेल एज द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ द लंग. माय डियर स्टूडेंट, कम टू द सेकेंड प्रोसेस, दैट इज गैसियस एक्सचेंज. गैसियस एक्सचेंज, डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस गैसियस एक्सचेंज दैट टेक्स प्लेस इन द एल्वियोलाई. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन द डायग्राम टू ऑल ऑफ यू ऑफ द एल्वियोलर सैक. दिस इज द एल्वियोलर सैक, एल्वियोलाई, दैट इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द लंग. एंड दिस एल्वियोलर सैक इज फुली सप्लाइड विद द दिस इज फुली सप्लाइड विद द आर्टरीज एंड वेन्स, द ब्लड कैपिलरीज विच आर ऑफ टू टाइप, आर्टरीज एंड वेन्स. And these arteries and veins are responsible for absorption of oxygen and diffusion of carbon dioxide, absorption of oxygen from this alveolar sac and diffusion of carbon dioxide from the blood capillary to the alveolar sac. So dear students, this is very simple diagram. If you want to draw, you can practice it so that you can understand well, because the biology, you cannot understand biology without diagram. So the diagram is the main weapon to understand the subject of biology. Dear students, this is the alveolar sac, and to understand the physiology you have to look it, you have to practice it so that your study can be completed. So dear students, this alveolar sac is, how does the oxygen and carbon dioxide get diffused? Take the example of the blood vessel. Suppose this is the blood vessel. So this is the artery. This is the vein. If this is the artery, first of all, take the example of the absorption of oxygen. Suppose this is the artery O. And the O2, it get diffused. In it, this is the blood. O2 get diffused in this. These are the blood cells, and in the veins, these veins that is indicating with a different color, the CO2 get diffused in the alveolar sac. So this phenomena is called the gaseous exchange. So my dear students, the gaseous exchange takes place in the alveoli. This is alveoli. These are the blood capillaries. These are the blood capillaries. This is the alveoli. And the oxygen, as far as oxygen is concerned, oxygen and carbon dioxide, you can indicate these gases in the form of these. So you can indicate these two, oxygen in the yellow color and CO2 in the white color. So this is the gaseous concentration. My dear student, our question is, how in a single alveolar sac the gaseous exchange of two takes place? My dear students, the hydrogen ion that is formed in all the living system, that is formed during the metabolic activities, and hydrogen ion is responsible for the exhausting of the carbon dioxide. Wherever hydrogen ion will be there, more concentration of hydrogen ion will be there, then there will be the removal of the carbon dioxide from that part. So in the alveolar sac, if hydrogen ion concentration will be more in the blood itself, if these veins, venules are having the hydrogen ion concentration more, then the carbon dioxide get released in the this alveolar sac. And if the hydrogen ion concentration will be less, then the absorption of oxygen takes place in this veins, in this arteries. So oxygen, O2 and CO2, O2 and CO2, you can write it CO2. So CO2 is coming out and O2 is going inside the blood vessel. So dear student, this is the mechanism of the gaseous exchange inside the alveolar sac, which is the end of the bronchiole, which is the end of the trachea, which is the end of the bronchus. So single bronchus that is coming in two lobes, in two divided part, in going to lungs, and that branches finally reach to the alveolar sac, which is a balloon like structure which facilitate the gaseous exchange. Dear student, come to the third part, and third part is the that is very essential, that is very important as far as the physiology of the respiration is concerned. And third part is the cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. So come to C, that is the cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. So students, in this cellular respiration, the respiration takes place, the oxidation takes place in the cell itself. So suppose this is a cell, this is an animal cell having the nucleus, this is mitochondria, mitochondria, this is cytoplasm, this is cytoplasm, cytoplasm. So what happened? The oxygen is coming in the mitochondria. Oxygen, O2 is coming into the mitochondria in it, and glucose C6H12O6, that is the energy providing molecule, that is coming in the cytoplasm. And the process of glycolysis and process of oxidation takes place in this complete cell. So cellular respiration can be studied, it can be studied in two parts. Number one glycolysis, or you can understand the cellular respiration by two means. One is without oxygen. Without oxygen, and number two with oxygen. So if oxygen will be not there, first of all the cellular respiration can be understood in both processes, aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is the respiration which completes with the oxygen. Without oxygen, the respiration cannot take place in the aerobic respiration. While anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. So my dear students, the cellular respiration that you will understand, considering these two conditions,
if oxygen will be available, then the reaction will be some other kind, and if oxygen will be not present, then the reaction will be of some other kind. So let us see number one, glycolysis. This is very important, dear students. So glycolysis always takes place. What happens in the first stage? The glycolysis of glucose C6H12O6 glycolysis in the cytoplasm. So glycolysis, when the glucose reaches there in the cytoplasm, then the glycolysis takes place, and this glycolysis results the breakdown of this glucose molecule. And pyruvate, the formation of pyruvate or pyruvic acid that will be formed in the cytoplasm. So the first process is the glycolysis, which takes place in the cytoplasm itself, and the conversion of glucose into the pyruvate molecule or pyruvic acid, where carbon will be C3. So this C6 get converted into C3. So two molecules of pyruvate will be formed. And in the second stage, when the oxygen is there in aerobic respiration plus O2, this oxidation takes place in the mitochondria, and this process is called oxidation. So mitochondria perform the process of oxidation, and which results the formation of CO2 plus H2O plus 38 ATP of energy will be liberated. So my dear students, this is the aerobic type of respiration. This is the aerobic. You can say that this part is aerobic, and if oxygen will be not there, then some other thing will be formed, and that you will study followed by this. So dear student, the glycolysis, the first step of the cellular respiration is the glycolysis, which takes place in the cytoplasm, and which results the formation of pyruvate or pyruvic acid. And in the presence of oxygen, this pyruvate or pyruvic acid get oxidized in mitochondria, and formation of carbon dioxide H2O and 38 ATP of energy. 38 ATP is the higher amount of energy that get liberated for the different functions in the higher animal or human, because this aerobic respiration, in the process of aerobic respiration, there will be the more liberation of the energy, so that particular animal or human can work more and more. So my dear students, this is the process of glycolysis and oxidation. Now dear students, come to the next, that is the, if oxygen will be not there, then what happens? That you see. दिस इज ऑक्सीडेशन, ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर टू ऑक्सीडेशन एंड नंबर थ्री, नंबर थ्री दिस पाइरूवेट मॉलिक्यूल फर्दर, दिस पाइरूवेट मॉलिक्यूल फर्दर इन एब्सेंस ऑफ ओ टू विच इज फाउंड इन द ईस्ट ईस्ट सेल द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सी थ्री एच फाइव ओ एच दिस इज द एल्कोहल प्लस प्लस CO2 प्लस 2 ATP ऑफ एनर्जी, दिस इज का फर्मेंटेशन. सो 3 इज द फर्मेंटेशन. सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन स्पेशली इन द ईस्ट सेल वेयर द आफ्टर द ग्लाइकोलिसिस दिस पाइरूवेट मॉलिक्यूल गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू द एल्कोहल दैट इज द C3H5OH एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड विल बी रिलीज्ड दैट इज स्पेशली इन द एल्कोहल इंडस्ट्री एज वेल एज इन द बेकरी इंडस्ट्री एंड 2 ATP ऑफ एनर्जी विल बी रिलीज्ड विच इज सफिशियंट फॉर द वर्क ऑफ दिस ईस्ट सेल. सो द फर्स्ट पार्ट वॉज द ग्लाइकोलिसिस, सेकेंड पार्ट इज द एरोबिक डिस्पोजिशन दैट इज द ऑक्सीडेशन, थर्ड पार्ट दैट इज द फर्मेंटेशन स्पेशली इन द ईस्ट सेल एंड फोर पार्ट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फोर पार्ट ऑफ द सेलुलर रिस्पिरेशन इज द लैक्टेट फर्मेंटेशन, लैक्टेट फर्मेंटेशन. नाउ सी व्हाट इज द लैक्टेट फर्मेंटेशन. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन अ रनर इज रनिंग मोर एंड मोर एंड मोर एंड he is getting oxygen by inhaling exhaling faster than the normal condition, then what happen, the muscular cells, striated muscles which are having the more nucleus, they are the multinucleate, then this pyruvate in the muscular cells starts producing energy and by the formation of where the oxygen is not more to complete the to provide the more and more energy to the muscular cell, then muscular cells, striated muscular cells produce lactic acid and that is called lactate fermentation. And what happen, formation of lactic acid plus 2 ATP of energy that will be released. So, in the that is why the striated muscles get somehow it get swell up, it get inflamed due to the high work, due to the high stress on the muscular cells. So, the formation of lactic acid in the muscular cells in the absence of oxygen is called lactate fermentation, where the formation of lactic acid and 2 ATP energy will be released in the that in the muscular cells. This is in muscular cells. So, my dear friend, this is the complete process of the respiration, complete physiology of the respiration, which you have seen in this digital video. And thank you very much for watching this video. If you watch carefully this video, then you will be able to learn this complete process of the respiration. Thank you.